Hello again, everyone. Today it is day 13 of the Diamine 2022 Inkvent calendar, and it looks like this one might be kind of an exciting one. It is Upon a Star, which is another chameleon ink. And so far the chameleon inks have been pretty interesting, and I can't tell. It looks like maybe a multicolor shimmer in there, but let's find out. So I'm going to go ahead and open the swatch book. And you can see the prior days here. I'll go ahead and show those real quick. That Memory Lane, I don't think it was fully dry yesterday when I showed you all that one. Really, really pretty. Really pretty. And Apple Teeny, I don't know. Still kind of on the fence about that one, and Cardinal. But Memory Lane and Dusted Truffle, super nice. Okay, so day 13. let me go ahead and zoom in here a little bit, and I'm going to take the cover off of my nib here. Okay. I'm going to shake this one more time because that shimmer, it settles really fast. Okay. And if I could suggest anything to Diamine for future years, make the plastic not so hard to get off. It's just crazy. Takes me a really long time. Whoa, this is super dark. I do like a dark blue. I'm gonna leave that one at the end a little lighter just to see. Whoa, that is really dark. My guess is that this ink is probably staining because it like completely colored my water right away. And as you can see, it seems pretty staining. All right, and let's go on to the Kakimori nib. And this one seems fairly wet. So this is Diamine Upon a Star. Okay. Yeah, nice. Yeah, definitely want to try and wipe that out of the nib because, like I said, I think this is probably going to be a staining ink. And it does look like it has a little bit of a purplish tint to it, so that could also be what's exacerbating the possible staining. I'm gonna try and get into some of these grooves in my Kakimori nib to see if I can get a little bit more clean. It hasn't been an issue, but a lot of people have suggested cleaning it with a toothbrush, and I may do that once it gets a little dirty or too dirty. Okay, so let's go ahead and put this up to the camera. So although I know it has shimmer and it's supposed to be a chameleon, let's see, let's keep talking for a little while and let this dry, because I'm sure you won't be able to see the full effect until it's dry. And this was a pretty light application, and as you can see in the writing, it's pretty dark. And I know I'm seeing some red shading here, but I'm not really seeing a lot of shimmer in the writing. I'm starting to see more shimmer here as this dries. So, like I said, let's just give it a second. And I'm not seeing a lot of shimmer here either, but I'm definitely seeing, you know, some sheen. I would call this more a sheening ink at this point. But yeah, you can definitely get some different color, like red and blue, but that's pretty normal for a sheening ink. So, and then, okay, so we're starting to see more of that shimmer up there. And yeah, I definitely think you can see that it's maybe green when you tilt it this way, and then more blue and red. I do feel like there, you know, shimmer aside, I do feel like there are a lot of inks sort of in this color tone, sort of dark blue with red. So we had last year we had Ruby Blues, which it's lighter. It's lighter than the Upon a Star. But let's see if we had anything else that's similar to that. Thunderbolt is definitely lighter. And that was the last day. So let's see. Yeah, and this one's more of a teal, a really dark teal. I love this one. Tempest. Oops, sorry, you can't see that too well. That was a really good one from last year's. I like that one a lot. And I would almost say that, even though they're calling the inks this year chameleons, I mean, I suppose you could say that that's a chameleon. I just call that shimmer. Let's see what the other chameleons look like. So Solar Storm, that was a chameleon, right? Yeah, and I forget now. Was Alpine supposed to be a chameleon? I don't remember. I don't think so. Maybe it was the spiced apple. Yeah, I think that was the one. But I would just really call them sheening and shimmering. Okay, so clearly I put a lot on there, but you can see where it's now dry up in here. It's pretty. I like that kind of ink. I would call this more of a reddish purple along the lines of like a dark ultramarine kind of color, whereas stuff from the prior years, like this one's more of a grayish blue, this one's more of a greenish blue, this one's more of a reddish blue, the ruby blues. But like I said, it is a lighter color, but not a whole lot. It's pretty close in the writing. But this is even bluer, I would say. This leaning a little bit more red. But anyway, and when I do the next day's ink, you'll be able to see this fully dry. So I'll show that off more then. All right, well, that was day 13 of the InkVent calendar. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like. Feel free to subscribe to keep track of future videos on my channel. And I hope to see you next time. But in the meantime, have a great day. Thanks so much. Bye.